Welcome students, this is a video lecture series on computer networks. This video lecture is about multiple access protocols. This topic comes under data link layer of OSI model. Let's start. If there is a shared medium and multiple stations are sharing the medium, there is no dedicated channel between sender and receiver, then there will be a possibility of interference and collision. Collision means access conflict due to which frames will be destroyed or modified. Collision will happen if more than one station try to access the same medium. So here we are going to discuss about the controlled access protocols of multiple access protocols. And the first one is pooling. It works with topologies in which one device is primary and other devices are secondary. So pooling will only work if there are two types of stations in which one is considered as a primary stations, or we can say server, and other devices are client stations or the secondary. So all the data exchanges will be done through the primary devices, or we can say through the server. Server will have all the rights to exchange the data. All the messages will go through the primary device. And primary device decides which device is allowed to use the channel. In this way, there will be no conflict because primary device is only going to decide that which device will send the message and which device will receive the message. So we can see the method of polling is, here we use a select function. So primary wants to send the data. It tells the secondary to get ready to receive using a select frame. There is a select function. Primary will send. Primary will initiate the communication and it will send select frame to the device. Here you can see in the picture that select function is primary has sent the select message to the B device. And if B is ready to receive the data, it will send an acknowledgement. Then primary will send the data, and then again when the data is received by B successfully, it will send an acknowledgement. So primary must have got the data from some other station and it is giving it to the B. So in this way, I am explaining it again. Like primary, if primary has some data for B, B is the receiver, primary has some data for B, then it will not send the data directly. It will first send a select function or select message to B. If B is ready to receive, it will send an acknowledgement. Then primary will start transferring the data. When the data is received by B successfully, it will again send the acknowledgement. In this way, primary will come to know that data is received by B. Yes, now there is a poll function. Poll function is used when some other station wants to send data to primary. As I have already told you, suppose here you can say there is a one primary station and A and B are two stations. So A and B, if they want to communicate, they cannot communicate directly. If A wants to send a data to B, then A must send the data to primary, then primary will transmit it to B. All the communication will take place via primary station. So now if primary wants to receive the data, then it will ask secondary devices if they have anything to send using the poll frame. Now the poll function is used to receive the data by the primary. Suppose A wants to send some data, so it has to wait for the poll message of primary until and unless it cannot send any data to primary. So primary will systematic way, it will send this poll function to each and every device in the system in the network. Suppose now we are seeing two responses that are possible. Suppose primary has sent a poll function to A, means it asks, basically poll means what? Primary is asking to A if A has anything to send. If A doesn't have anything to send, it will send a negative acknowledgement. It has nothing to send. Okay, now primary again poll for B. Now B has some data to send to some other device, so it will send the data directly. And then when the data will be received successfully by the primary, primary will send an acknowledgement to B. In this way, primary will receive the data, and already you have studied the select function. We have discussed it already, and that way primary will send the data to other stations. In this way, this communication takes place. Now we have the next method, which is the token passing method. Basically, the method we have studied previously, which is the polling function, it can only be implemented in the systems where there is a server and client, or there are primary stations and secondary stations. But if there is some system, some network which doesn't have proper client and server differentiation, or they don't have devices primary and secondary, we cannot distribute the devices as primary and secondary, then stations are organized, then we can use the other method, which is token passing, in which stations are organized into a logical ring. Here we are talking about the logical ring, means it is not necessary that ring topology is only used. Logically, they must have be arranged in the form of ring. What is the meaning of logically arrangement? It means each and every station must have a predecessor, and each station must have a successor. If there is such arrangement, then we can say that there is a logical ring. Yes. Now the special packet called token circulates through the ring from one device to another, and so on. The system which has the position of token, which is having the token currently, can send the data. When station has no more data to send, it will release the token and pass it to the successor. In this way, the token circulates through the ring, and the person having token will send the data to the destination. In this way, there is no conflict. No other station is sending. Each and every station is using the channel. Only the station can send who is having the token. And since there is only one token, so at a time, only one station can send. In this way, all conflicts are removed. What is the problems that are associated with the token passing? It is the token management. Basically, we have to manage the token, means like there must be some rules that how much time a station can hold the token and all, and the priority and the starvation. These problems may arise in the token passing. And also, if some way token is lost, then the communication will be disturbed. So these are some issues that are in that we face in token passing method. Yes, now we come to channelization. Channelization is a very controlled access method. Here already we have distributed the channel for each and every device which is in the system. So it is a very systematic method. There are three methods of channelization. One is on the basis of time, one is on the basis of frequency, and one is on the basis of code. So we can divide, it is same as suppose there is a highway and we divide it into four lanes, and each and everybody is using a different lane for communication, for going from source to destination. In this way, the packets, in this way we divide the time or frequency among the users, and they use their different bands to communicate, to send their messages, and there will be no interference because each one is using a different band or different way to communicate the message and communicate the data packets. So we will further discuss this topic, channelization, in our next video lecture. So thank you very much.